Hey everyone, Caront here, and welcome to 2017 at last. Yeah, I know, I'm 2.5 weeks late, but meh, oh well. I've actually tried to film this vlog a couple of times last week, but as it turns out, well, it's kind of tough when you start using your webcam for streams along with the snowball, and then apparently your webcam won't record any sound without the snowball, even in its native application, which is what I'm using now, so go figure. Anyway. Yay 2017 and yay 2016. And that's the first thing I want to mention is thank you guys for a great year. In terms of metrics for YouTube, which is really about the only metrics I have, Twitch metrics, I can't really find all that well, and I'm not sure how much to lean on them anyway. But the YouTube metrics for 2016, pretty much across the board, were a lot better than last year or the previous year. And granted, I've only been doing this for a little over 2 years, so that's to be expected, I guess, if a community's growing, but everything pretty much that I could find was higher. I mean, I've gotten the majority of my subscribers this year, or this past year. My views and view times went up probably something in the neighborhood of, I think, over 100% over last year, which is really nice. And I also got more comments. Actually, I don't know about more comments, but I've gotten a lot of feedback, of course, from the episodes and such. So pretty much everything that I can think of as far as YouTube metrics has been better this year. So thank you. I really appreciate it. For those of you who have been here basically since the beginning, I thank you very much. The fact that you have watched me grow through 2.5 years of YouTubing and almost 2 years of Twitch streaming, it really means a lot to me. Because you've been here when I was crappy, and you've been here when I've gotten better. I would still argue I'm only really kind of decent now, but you have seen me change a lot of things, and I think for the most part change things for the better, so thank you for that. For those of you who have recently arrived, well, welcome. Hopefully you're enjoying your time here, and whether you're watching my current Let's Play of Tactics, or whether you're watching past Let's Plays, because I've gotten comments from people watching through Tales of the Abyss. I've gotten people watching back through Suikoden 2, which is my most popular series by leaps and bounds. And I've even gotten comments from people watching through Wild Arms, so it's great. I really love it. Alright, so what's going to be going on this year? Well, first thing, I will talk about sort of where we were last year in terms of LPs and streams. In terms of Let's Plays, we started out the year, we were going through Tales of the Abyss, which started the previous November and finished up midway through the year, and then we started on Final Fantasy Tactics, which is actually about to finish up with the episode that I'm going to be posting on Thursday, so that's basically the Let's Play side of it. In terms of streams, we started with Breath of Fire 4, finished that up, and then ended up starting a playthrough of Pokemon White, which was a lot of fun. It's my most popular stream by far as new viewers and new followers and all that good stuff. After that was finished up, I was also doing Dragon Quest VIII on originally Wednesdays, now Tuesdays. I finished up Dragon Quest VIII in December and started Final Fantasy V after that, which I'm doing right now. In terms of the Saturday-Sunday block, after finishing Pokemon White, we did Child of Light, a gorgeous, very atmospheric RPG that is really good. Then we did Shadow of the Colossus, which is considered by many to be a masterpiece. It's lovely. It's an interesting concept for a game. Controls are touchy, but it was still a fun game nonetheless. It was good, particularly in the puzzle-solving aspect. Me trying to figure out how to beat the Colossi and sometimes not doing so well. But it was still a lot of fun anyway. Then we played Uncharted 4. We went through and finished up, I would assume finished up, Nathan Drake's saga as he went through the pirate havens and discovered that there was this grand pirate war with the greatest pirate basically to ever live, Henry Avery. And then we found the treasure and had a sword fight for it and then, well, lost most of it anyway. Oh well. But yeah, it was still a lot of fun anyway. So yeah, it was a really fun year. And I am currently doing Final Fantasy V in terms of stream, and on the Saturday-Sunday block, I am doing Paper Mario, both of which are a lot of fun. I will, in terms of Let's Plays, I am going to begin Skies of Arcadia next Tuesday. So for folks who are maybe thinking I'm going to be taking some time off between Let's Plays, nope. I didn't take a break between Suikoden 2 and Tales of the Abyss, and I'm not taking a break between these two either. So, yeah. Or between Tales of the Abyss and Final Fantasy Tactics. I'm not taking a break between these either because I want to go ahead and get started. As a reminder, Skies of Arcadia will be blind, so please don't spoil. But if you want to kind of gently nudge me in the right direction on occasion, that's fine. Just try to do so without spoiling anything. I mean, it's basically the same policy I operated under with Suikoden 2, where some of my commenters helped me out as far as, hey, this you might want to look here, here, or here in order to find recruits. But they didn't spoil me as to who they were or what they did or how good they were or what have you. So any of that sort of help, that would be nice. Just try not to spoil anything for me because I do want to experience it as a blind Let's Play, just like I did with Suikoden 2, which was go through it all, see it all for the first time, and just really revel in it. And I want to do that with Skies, too. So that's, I guess, my dictum as far as that goes, so to speak. As far as what I'm going to be doing after that, I'm still considering. Like I mentioned earlier, it's going to be between Chrono Cross and Suikoden 5. I will admit, I'm probably leaning in the direction of Suikoden 5, although I'm not sure yet. Like I said, still thinking about it. But that's kind of where my thoughts are at the moment. After that, I have no idea. That's probably going to finish out the year, so I don't think we're going to be talking about new Let's Plays at any point until 2018. Well, after that, anyway. On the streaming side, like I said, we're going to be doing Final Fantasy V for the next little bit. I think we're probably, let's see, we did Episode 6 yesterday. So I expect we're probably about halfway through the game, roughly. And once we finish that up, I am going to be going on to a bit of a threefer. It is going to be a mixture of Legend of Zelda Majora's Mask, the standard edition. I don't have a 3DS for 3D, so sorry. It's going to be the regular edition. And then Super Metroid and a Castlevania game yet to be determined on the GBA. I'm not sure if it's going to be Circle of the Moon or Aria of Sorrow or whatever the third one is. I've looked into the games, and it seems as though all three of them are pretty well regarded, so it might just be a toss-up for whatever I feel like doing whenever the time comes. I'm not quite sure what order I'm going to do them in, but I'm thinking, I don't know. I'm not sure whether I want to do Majora's Mask first or last. I don't want it to be the middle game, though, I know that. I want, probably what the order I would do it in is either Majora's Mask, Castlevania whatever, and Super Metroid, or Super Metroid, Castlevania whatever, and then Majora's Mask. So I would plant Castlevania firmly in the middle of the three, but that's likely what I would do, and I'm not sure exactly what yet. So that's just my thoughts on stream. Now, once I get done with Paper Mario, I'm going to continue on to do the Thousand Year Door, because I'm really enjoying Paper Mario so far, and I want to continue that. So the Saturday-Sunday block is going to be set for a while. The Tuesday block is, well, you pretty much got the next three games. Now, what I plan on doing after that, I really have no idea. I'm going to look on my list of games and also look into maybe some other games that I want to stream and pretty much go from there. I really haven't the foggiest clue what I'm going to do after those three, so that's very much going to be up in the air. Maybe I'll do Pokemon White 2, I don't know. I'm just thinking about it. In terms of events for the year, in terms of just general stuff, I want to do a charity stream in May. I've talked about this a little bit before, so those of you who watch my vlogs already know about it. So it's not exactly going to be new news to you, but I do want to do a charity stream in May. I haven't the foggiest idea what I want to do it with in terms of the game slash games. So what I'm likely going to end up doing is, after this is over with, I'm probably going to put together a straw poll for you guys to vote on. Because in the absence of I can't figure out what I'm doing, I leave it to you guys. So I'm going to get a straw poll up, and I'll post it, the link in the description, as I generally do, just to give you guys the option or the choice as far as what you want to see from a charity stream of mine. It will be in May after classes finish up, so it's likely going to be sometime around May 9th or 10th. I'm not sure exactly. It depends on how the calendar schemes out. If I'm remembering the calendar correctly and May 1st is a Monday, then I would likely do the charity stream on May 9th. That would be that Tuesday, of course, or the following Tuesday, I should say. I will be out of classes. I won't have any work obligations. I won't have any tutoring because tutoring ends that week too. Well, the first week, I should say. So I would be just completely freed up. I could do a long stream for as long as my little body is willing to go. Now, I pulled off 17 hours with Super Mario RPG, so hopefully I'd be able to go a little bit longer with that. But to a fair degree, honestly, it kind of depends on how I'm feeling. It also depends on how it's going as far as energy level from my audience and what have you. So we'll see. Now, as far as who I want to do it for, I've spoken with my sister, who has a really cute nephew, my nephew Peyton, well, her son, my nephew. He's 9 years old, and he suffered a series of microstrokes in his brain over the last year. I've not talked about this really all that much on camera, so apologies if I'm a little spare on details, because to some degree I don't have them. But over the last year, in fact, that was how he greeted me when he came home for Christmas. Uncle Eric, it's my 1 year stroke anniversary, which almost had me dissolving on the floor. But he started having strokes not this year, not this past year, but the previous December, right close to Christmas time. They didn't know it yet because they thought he was just having headaches. As it turns out, he had broken a blood vessel in his neck playing football, just catch football in the yard, and that had clotted up because of a series of complications, and he had started having mini strokes in his brain. Ultimately, what resulted from that was he lost his peripheral vision, and he also had to have neck surgery. Basically, he lost a fair bit of mobility in his neck, too. They were trying to brace it to keep the vessels from tearing again. So, since that point, I mean, obviously, the whole family and everybody's been following his progress, and he's adapted fairly well. Granted, I've not seen him very much, so I don't know the worst of it, but when he came home for Christmas, he was a 9-year-old. I mean, he was playing, running around. We ended up playing Pokemon and the Pokemon trading card game, of all things. So, I mean, he just resilient as all hell, pretty much. So, I say that to basically to mention, and yeah, tear up a little bit, so sorry. But I say that to mention that I want to do something in May with a group that's close to what he had done. So I spoke with my sister about it, and one of the groups that she cited was Children's Miracle Network, which I'm already doing that for Extra Life, so that's pretty much taken care of. But she also mentioned a couple of other groups, one of which is really, really small, and I'm not sure the resources would be there, or I don't even know if they'd be able to facilitate an event like what I would want to do for donations. So I'm most likely going to do the charity stream in May for Make-A-Wish. Make-A-Wish Foundation provides basically dream opportunities for young children who are facing not just problems like Peyton has with pediatric strokes, but pretty much anything and everything that they're going through. And so Peyton is going to be a beneficiary of that. I don't want to say exactly because that would be getting a little bit too much into privacy stuff, I think. But he is going to be a beneficiary of Make-A-Wish. And so I want to, I mean, basically give back pretty much. So that's the group that I'm likely going to do it for. I need to speak with them and make sure everything's good first. But that's my plan anyway. So that's going to be May, like I said, probably May 9th. And I'm going to put the straw poll up in the description so that you guys will have a say so that you guys can vote on what I want to do, because I'm thinking about doing potentially four. And obviously, I won't do all four. I'll just do one of them. But what I'm thinking about in terms of possibilities, just in case, and these are ones I've mentioned before, so if you've heard it, then it's going to be a little bit of a repeat. But just in case you haven't, it's going to be What I'm thinking about is either marathon runs of all the Super Mario games I can get to, and yes, that would include the Lost Levels, meaning the real Super Mario Brothers 2, or I might end up doing a Mega Man marathon of all the Mega Man games I can find. I would probably do the Mega Man Legacy Collection on Steam, although I'm not sure yet. I obviously have to buy it first. Or I might do a long stream of Suikoden 2, just to sort of revisit it. Or I might do a long stream of Chrono Trigger DS. Like I said, I've got a few options, so... And I... Honestly, there's part of me that wants to do any of those four, so... That's why I'm throwing it to you guys, because I can't make up my mind. And I don't think I'm going to be able to in the next 4 months. So, that's that. I am going to be doing Extra Life in November. I actually already have registered for it. I haven't done much with my site yet, so... I mean, if you go looking for it, you're not going to find anything except what's the stock there right now. This year, my goal for Extra Life is going to be $200. Because we raised $210 last year... I think we can equal and exceed that this time. My goal for the charity stream in May is I don't have a goal because it's a new, well, I say new thing, but I'm not going to set any sort of expectation on that, mostly just because it's still very much in the planning stages right now. And with Extra Life, I had a good bit more time to kind of cogitate on it and think of things and come up with things. But I will go ahead and mention in regards to what I'm going to be doing in May, I'm already getting prize stuff ready. I've got several things actually sitting in my trunk right now that I have bought from mostly GameStop, just some stuff that they've had on sale that I could get fairly easily that I think will go over well. I hope so. I'm not going to reveal them until we get much closer to the time, but I do have some stuff that I'm going to have in terms of possible incentives to hopefully, you know, hopefully for people to donate. So that's that. As far as Extra Life, I mean, it'll be the same way. I'll have donation incentives for that, too. But that'll be obviously much closer to that time as well. Let's see. I think that's pretty much it as far as charity or as far as events on the stream so far. As far as how the channels are doing, I've mentioned the metrics on YouTube are good and everything. I do want to mention, as it stands right now, I am at 373 TwitchTubers. Because I have 208 subscribers on YouTube and 165 followers on Twitch. So my goal in terms of numbers, I guess, although I'm not a big fan of setting number goals like that, is I think 400 TwitchTubers is pretty much just a matter of time. I think I will reach that sometime this year, almost certainly. What I'm going to be pushing for is to try to get to 500. If I can get to 500 TwitchTubers, again, you know, it's a combination, so it could be really either one. Or, I mean, a combination of both, obviously, in either direction, then I will see about doing another subscriber special. I don't know what that would be yet, whether it would be maybe a top five list of some sort, or, I mean, I'm really not sure. I've given it some thought in the last little bit, but I haven't come up with much of anything. I mean, long streams seem a bit played out, given that I have a penchant for doing them for charities and pretty much whenever I feel like it, so... Eh. But I don't know. If that's what I end up doing, then that's what I end up doing. But I'm just still very much in the thinking stages on that right now. One other thing I will mention in regards to the channel and everything is a week or two ago, some very, very generous friends on Twitch, a couple of folks in particular, Hero, Shadow, and Alan, donated. And thank you guys for that very much. I didn't... anticipated at all, so I was sitting here going the whole time, but yeah, so they donated very graciously and they allowed me to get the first item, well, really the only item on my wish list right now, but the item on my wish list. And it just so happens, had I filmed this last week and pulled it off, I wouldn't have been able to, well, show you because the package was sitting on my doorstep when I got back today. So you guys get to do, I wouldn't call it an unboxing because it's not a box, but we get to do something of an impromptu unboxing. Now, pardon, this is going to be a bit loud. Okay, more than a bit loud, I think. But what I wanted was some acoustic foam for mostly the window because I'm close to a pretty busy street. Cars come all the time, so I wanted to get that out of my recordings as best as possible. So I ordered, thanks to the donations, I ordered a couple of sets of foam. So, oh gosh, it might take me a while to unbox this. Yeah, man, they packed this really well. Okay, I might just go Hulk on this thing and just rip it open. Ah, there we go. Ah. Okay. Here we go. And, wow, they tied this thing really well, too. My goodness. I guess I can't fault whoever packed this thing. let's see. Here we are. All right. All right. Well, it wasn't quite as pokey as I would have thought, but here's your foam. And, man, it smells very chemical, too. So I got a couple of sets of them, or a couple, I think 24-pack, although I wonder at their definition. I have to check and see if I got sent the right stuff. But, yeah, so that's the acoustic foam. I will, oh, here, oh, never mind. I was looking at it wrong. Okay, there we go. This is it. So yeah, I got sent all the right stuff and everything. So now I'm going to be looking into installing this in the window, so that hopefully I can get all of this blocked out and be a better streamer and such. And then also seeing about how I can wrap it around the mic here so that, well, everything doesn't go reflecting all over the dang place all the time. So, yay! Thank you, guys. As far as, I guess, donation-type stuff, I really appreciate it. I'm not going to be the sort of person to sit here and beg for donations because, I mean, I'm just not that sort of person anyway. I do have a link on my, or through my Twitch page, though, if anybody wants to donate. I'll probably post a link in this video just so that you can get to it a little bit easier if you choose to. If you don't want to donate or don't have the money to donate, please don't feel obligated to. I appreciate any donations I get, and I actually have a little bit of extra money from what they gave me, so I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it yet. I may just sort of roll it in to maybe get something else. I don't know yet. But if you want to donate, then great. I've really appreciated it. It just blew me away whenever they started giving money. I'm like, what the? What? So, but yeah, if you do, then thank you very much. I really appreciate it, and I probably don't deserve a bit of it, but I'm appreciate that you guys think I do. But if you don't, or if you don't have the money, just don't worry about it. I appreciate that you guys come in and watch my streams and my Let's Plays and put up with my hijinks from time to time and have been willing to give for charity, and everything that you guys do has been wonderful. So the fact that I've gotten a little bit of support in terms of just straight out monetary stuff is great, but I'm not going to sit here and go, please give me money, because I just don't work that way. And I'm certainly not going to try to force anybody's hand. So if you want to, by all means. If not, no problem. Don't worry about it. Just tune in, keep me company, have fun, thwack me upside the head when I need it. And that's really all that I want, all that I need from you guys. And anything extra is a wonderful bonus. That's the best way I can think to put it. So, I can't really think of anything else. Not right offhand, anyway. I will say, though, actually, on a personal note, my biggest personal goal, I guess, for this year is going to be resetting the weight loss thing. And I feel like an idiot for saying I have to reset it. But ever since I did that video in July, I've sort of regressed backwards a little bit. It was a rough few months. Plus, my diet was not all that great, so I deserve what I get on that front. But I'm rolling it back again, or redoing it again, and have started taking steps in that right direction. I'm back in the gym more. My diet is changing to where I'm focusing more on fruits and veggies. I need to focus still more on fruits and veggies, but again, it's work in progress. And I've started walking to my tutoring, which is about 2 miles round trip. That'll be 4 days a week. So I'm getting more active. I'm getting better stuff into me to a pretty good degree. I'm watching my calories again, which I'm not formally counting them because that just drives me nuts, but I'm watching my calories again, and so hopefully my goal for this next 12 months, for, and yes, I'm giving myself the entire year because I'm going to need it, My goal for this next 12 months is to lose 60 pounds, to get down to about 185. I don't know if I'm going to be able to pull it off because I am 35 years old and my metabolism ain't that great. Never was, but now that I'm getting old, it's even less great. But I'm working on it. I'm working in that direction. And hopefully over the year, I will be able to at least show some results to be able to say, hey, guess what? I'm not porky anymore. I'm just maybe porkish or something like that. I don't know. Ultimately, my goal is to get back into running marathons again. I don't know if I'll be able to do that this year because I think that might be pushing it a little bit, particularly where I'm starting. But if nothing else, by the end of next year, I want to be running marathons again so that I can look at my 12 medals in my little medal holder thingy that I have yet to actually unbox. And yes, I've been in this apartment for 6 months. But I want to be able to look at those and say, hey, guess what? You guys are getting some company soon. So that's ultimately the goal, I think. Okay, now I think I am done. But, yeah, so I guess TLDR, thank you for everything. Hopefully you guys stick with me in 2017. I'm really looking forward to Skies. I'm looking forward to pretty much everything else that's going to be happening. And, yeah, so I really appreciate it. You guys are wonderful. I mean, I couldn't find any better followers, subscribers, viewers, commenters, thwack me upside the headers, givers of all stripes. I mean, I couldn't find anybody better. So thank you guys. Hopefully by the end of the year, there will be more of you, but we'll see how it goes. So with that, I'm going to go ahead and head off, and it's probably actually about time for me to go to tutoring now, so yeah. But I will be releasing my next, actually, and final episode of Final Fantasy Tactics tomorrow, and then I'll see you guys in Skies of Arcadia. So thank you guys for joining me, and I'll see y'all later.